Welcome to this El Nino update created October 19th, 2015. My name is Mark O'Malley with the National Weather Service in Phoenix. El Nino conditions have been present in the equatorial Pacific since last winter. However, in the past 6 months, sea surface temperatures have steadily increased. Currently, strong El Nino conditions are developing, with temperature anomalies solidly above the 1.5 Celsius threshold. For impacts affecting the United States, we look at sea surface temperature anomalies near this 3.4 Niño region. In these images and animations, measurements in this key Niño 3.4 region have easily eclipsed the 1.5 Celsius threshold, as shown by this purple line indicating this strong El Niño event. When forecasting El Niño, sea surface temperatures can usually be traced to the evolution of water below the surface. Organized deep ocean waves can move massive amounts of water west to east and from the ocean depths to the surface. For much of 2015, numerous strong deep ocean waves have unlocked a very large reservoir of unusually warm water up to the surface. As a result, the measurement of El Niño has been growing steadily stronger and has allowed a robust linkage between the ocean and atmosphere to materialize. Very warm water remains below the surface this autumn, ensuring this El Niño episode will persist through the winter season. We can look at sea surface temperature anomalies across the entire Pacific Basin for hints as to what could happen in the atmosphere during this upcoming fall and winter. A classic El Niño plume of very warm water has been maintained across the East Tropical Pacific. In addition, a large mass of much warmer than normal water has been sitting along the west coast of North America. This may help support the maintenance of the tropical El Niño plume, though forcing associated with the El Niño plume may dominate or mask the influence of this more North Pacific warm water. And lastly, waters have cooled somewhat over the West Pacific, resembling a mature El Niño phase, and thus allowing the tropical thunderstorms to shift eastward into the Central Pacific. The atmospheric response during the strong El Niño has been very pronounced since the summer. Concentrated clusters of thunderstorms have been more persistent over the east central tropical Pacific. This is one definitive sign of a more robust El Niño. Also, the typical low-level easterly trade winds along the equator have been periodically absent, and instead bursts of westerly winds have replaced these trade winds, allowing the warm waters to be maintained in the eastern Pacific. And in the past month, many locations across the southwest United States have been wetter than usual, which is another sign the atmospheric flow has responded. So in summary, El Niño conditions have become well established over the Pacific, and the atmospheric pattern has already responded. This will be a strong El Niño and will continue to influence our weather and the atmospheric flow through the fall and the winter. Thank you for viewing this multimedia briefing, and please check out our companion briefing on the winter forecast. You may find us on the web, Facebook, and Twitter at the address listed here.